गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज टाइप्स ऑफ सिजोफ्रेनिया। टाइप्स ऑफ सिजोफ्रेनिया के अंदर अपन देखते हैं फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कैटाटोनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया। कैटाटोनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया, कैटा मीन्स डिस्टर्ब्ड टोनिक टोन, इज कैरेक्टराइज बाई ए मार्क डिस्टर्बेंस ऑफ मोटर बिहेवियर। जो मोटर बिहेवियर है उसके अंदर बेसिकली जो डिस्टरबेंस अराइज होती है उसी को बोलते हैं कैटाटोनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया। इट कैन प्रेजेंट इन थ्री क्लिनिकल फॉर्म्स, एक्साइटेड कैटाटोनिया, स्टुपरस कैटाटोनिया एंड कैटाटोनिया अलर्टिंग बिटवीन एक्साइटमेंट एंड स्टुपर। देन एक्साइटेड कैटाटोनिया, दिस इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द फॉलोइंग फीचर्स: इंक्रीज इन साइकोमोटर एक्टिविटी रेंजिंग फ्रॉम रेस्टलेसनेस, एजिटेशन, एक्साइटमेंट, एग्रेसिवनेस टू एट टाइम्स वायलेंट बिहेवियर, इंक्रीज इन स्पीड, लूजनिंग ऑफ एसोसिएशन एंड फ्रेंक इनकॉरेंस। द एक्साइटमेंट इज नॉट गोल डायरेक्टेड एज नो रिलेशनशिप विद द एक्सटर्नल एनवायरमेंट, इंस्टेड इनर स्टिमुलाई एग्जाम्पल थॉट एंड इम्पल्स इन्फ्लुएंस द एक्साइटेड बिहेवियर। देन sometimes the excitement can become very severe and is accompanied by rigidity, hyperthermia and dehydration, finally culminating in death, which is known as acute lethal catatonia or pernicious catatonia. With the availability of new treatment choices and early diagnosis and treatment, lethal catatonia has become increasingly rare in most part of the world. Then stuporous or retained catatonia, this is characterized by extreme retardation of psychomotor function, delusion and hallucination may be present but are usually not prominent. Not all the features are present at the same time. जो सारे के सारे सिम्टम्स है सेम टाइम के अंदर प्रेजेंट होना उनका जरूरी नहीं है। देन क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ रिटेंड स्टुपर्स कैटाटोनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया आर म्यूटिज्म, रेजिडिटी, नेगेटिविज्म, पोस्टरिंग एंड स्टुपर, इकोलेलिया, इकोप्रेक्सिया, वैक्सी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, एम्बी टेंडेंसी, अदर साइन सच एज मैनरिज्म, स्टीरोटाइप्स, वर्बल एंड बिहेवियरल, ऑटोमेटिक ओबीडियंस, कमांड्स आर फॉलोड ऑटोमेटिकली इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ देयर नेचर एंड वर्बिग्रेशन, इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल स्पीच। देन कैटाटोनिया अलर्टनिंग बिटवीन एक्साइटमेंट एंड स्टूपर, दिस क्लिनिकल फीचर इज वेरी कॉमन विथ फीचर्स ऑफ बोथ एक्साइटेड कैटाटोनिया एंड स्टूपरस कैटाटोनिया अल्टरनेटली प्रजेंट। पैरानॉइड सिजोफ्रेनिया, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द पैरानॉइड सिजोफ्रेनिया। पैरानॉइड सिजोफ्रेनिया इज कैरेक्टराइज बाई द फॉलोइंग क्लिनिकल फीचर्स: फर्स्ट, डिल्यूजन ऑफ परसिक्यूशन, रेफरेंस ग्रैंडुलर कंट्रोल ऑफ इनफिडिलिटी और जेलसी, हलुसिनेटरी वॉइस दैट थ्रेटन और कमांड द पेशेंट और ऑडिटरी हलुसिनेशन विद आउट वर्बल फॉर्म सच एज विस्लिंग, humming and laughing. Then no prominent disturbance of affect, violation, speech and motor behavior. Then paranoid schizophrenia has a good prognosis if treated early. Then personality deterioration is minimal and most of these patients are productive and can lead a normal life. Now the third type of schizophrenia is disorganized or हैबिफ्रेनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया। डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड और हैबिट सिजोफ्रेनिया के अंदर अपन देखते हैं कि इसके अंदर डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड स्पीच, थिंकिंग एंड इमोशन एंड बिहेवियर जो पेशेंट के अंदर होते हैं वो सारे के सारे डिसऑर्गेनाइज हो जाते हैं, तो इसीलिए इसको बोलते हैं डिसऑर्गेनाइज और हैबिफ्रेनिक सिजोफ्रेनिया। डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड सिजोफ्रेनिया इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द फॉलोइंग फीचर्स, इसके कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट लक्षण होते हैं जिसके अंदर मार्क्ड थॉट डिसऑर्डर, इनकोहेरेंस एंड सीवियर लूजिंग ऑफ एसोसिएशन, डिल्यूजन एंड हॉलुसिनेशन आर फ्रेगमेंट्री एंड चेंजेबल। देन इमोशनल डिस्टर्बेंस सच एज इनअप्रोप्रिएट अफेक्ट,
blunted affect or senseless giggling. Disorganized behavior such as mannerism, mirror gazing for long periods of time, poor self-care and hygiene, markedly impaired social and occupational functioning, extreme social withdrawal and other oddities of behavior. Then the criteria are not met for catatonic type. The onset is insidious, usually in the early second decade. Hemiphrenic schizophrenia has one of the worst prognosis among the other subtypes of schizophrenia because of severe deterioration without any significant remission usually occurs over time. So, सबसे खराब जो prognosis है वो इसी schizophrenia के type का है. Then, fourth number is residual chronic schizophrenia. This schizophrenia also known as chronic schizophrenia. In this, active symptoms like delusion and hallucination are reduced but not completely free and negative symptoms have been present. Then, it is chronic form of schizophrenia with predominant negative symptoms like apathy, lack of drive, slowness and social withdrawal. The residual schizophrenia is diagnosed only after at least one episode has occurred. Then simple schizophrenia. Although called simple, it is one of the subtype which is the most difficult to diagnose. It is characterized by an early onset, early second decade, very insidious and progressive course, presence of negative symptoms such as marked social withdrawal, shallow emotional response with loss of initiative and drive and wandering aimlessly. Then delusion and hallucination are usually absent, and if present they are short lasting and poorly stigmatized. The prognosis is usually very poor. जो इसका prognosis है वो भी काफ़ी ज़्यादा poor है. Then post schizophrenia depression. This is the another type of schizophrenia. In this post schizophrenia depression, patient develop depressive features within 12 months of an acute episode of schizophrenia. In the presence of residual or active features of schizophrenia and are associated with an increased risk of suicide. The depressive features occurs due to side effect of antipsychotics, ragging, insight after recovery, or just be an integral part of schizophrenia. Then seven type of the schizophrenia is type first and type second schizophrenia. T.J. Crow had divided schizophrenia into two subtypes, namely type 1st and type 2nd schizophrenia. First, type 1st schizophrenia is characterized by the positive symptoms, and type 2nd schizophrenia is predominantly characterized by the presence of negative symptoms. Then undifferentiated schizophrenia, patient is in this category have the characteristics positive and negative symptoms of schizophrenia but not meet the specific criteria for the paranoid, disorganized or catatonic subtypes. Then the diagnosis of the schizophrenia is test like blood test, CBC and other tests, imaging studies, CT, MR, then psychological evaluation. A specialist will assess the patient's mental state by asking about thoughts, mood, hallucination, suicidal threat, violent tendency or potential for violence, as well as observing their demeanor and appearance. Then the patient must meet the criteria laid down in the DSM, Diagnostic Statistical Manual, have at least two of the following typical symptoms of schizophrenia. 1 month period for less if successfully treated. Delusion, hallucination, disorganized speech, grossly disorganized or catatonic behavior, negative symptoms, example affective flattening, alogia or avolition. Then experience considerable impairment in the ability to attend school, carry out their work duties or carry out everyday tasks. Then have symptoms like persist for 6 months or more. Then significant impairment in work or interpersonal relationship or self-care below the level of previous function. Then the treatment of the schizophrenia. The treatment of schizophrenia depends on the patient stage on phase. Patients in the acute phase are hospitalized in most cases to prevent harm to the patient or other and to being treatment with antipsychotic medications. Then indication for hospitalization are neglect of food and water intake, danger to self or others, poor treatment adherence, significant neglect of self-care or lack of social support with evidence of above mentioned risk. The treatment of schizophrenia can be discussed under the following headings like pharmacological treatment, electroconvulsive therapy, ECT, psychosocial therapy, then psychosocial rehabilitation. In this pharmacological therapy, typical classical first generation antipsychotic drugs are used. Like an acute episode of schizophrenia is treated with classic typical antipsychotic agent, which are most effective in the presence of acute excitement. They are chlorpromazine 300 to 150 mg per day per orally, 50 to 100 mg per day intramuscular IM, flozapine diconate 25 to 30 mg IM, then every 1 to 3 weeks. Then haloperidol 5 to 100 mg per day per oral, 5 to 20 mg per day IM, trifluoperazine 15 to 60 mg per day per oral, 1 to 5 mg per day intramuscular, clozapine 25 to 450 mg per day per orally. Atypical second generation antipsychotic drugs are atypical antipsychotic drugs risperidone, olanzapine, Jasperidone are more usual when the negative symptoms are prominent. Example in chronic schizophrenia, they are risperidone 2 to 10 mg per day per orally, olanzapine 10 to 20 mg per day per oral. Then anti-anxiety drugs, example lorazepam, diazepam, alprazolam can be used to control agitation and associated sleeping disturbance. Anti-Parkinsonian drugs to prevent extrapyramidal side effects, example 3-hexaphenidine 6 mg per day, orphanodrine 150 mg per day, procyclidine 7.5 to 15 mg per day. Then electroconvulsive therapy, ECT. Schizophrenia is not a primary indication for ECT. The indication for ECT in schizophrenia include catatonic stupor, uncontrolled catatonic excitement, acute excitement not controlled with drugs, severe side effects with drugs in presence of untreated schizophrenia. Usually 8 to 12 ECTs are recommended, although up to 18 have been given in poor responder, administered 2 or 3 times a week. Then psychological therapy, psychoeducation of the patient and especially the family caregivers regarding the nature of illness and its course and treatment help in establishing a good therapeutic relationship with the patient and the family. Then group psychotherapy is particularly aimed at teaching problem solving and communication skill. Behavior therapy is useful reducing the frequency of bizarre, disturbing and deviant behavior and encouraging appropriate behaviors. Then family therapy. Family members are also provided social skill training to enhance communication and help decrease intrafamiliar tensions, decrease the expressed emotion of significant others in the family and raise awareness regarding decreasing expectation and avoiding critical remarks, emotional over-involvement and hostility. Then psychosocial rehabilitation. Psychosocial rehabilitation include activity therapy to develop the work habit, training in a new vocation or retraining in a previous skill, vocational guidance, independent job placement, sheltered employment or self-employment, and occupational therapy. Then nursing management. Nursing diagnosis of the schizophrenia is just a thought process related to inability to trust पैनिक एंजाइटी पॉसिबल हेरिडिटरी और बायोकेमिकल फैक्टर्स एविडेंस बाय डेल्यूजनल थिंकिंग इनएबिलिटी टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट इम्पेयर्ड वॉल्यूशन इनएबिलिटी टू प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व एब्स्ट्रैक्ट एक्सट्रीम सस्पिशियसनेस ऑफ अदर एंड सेकेंड इज डिस्टर्ब सेंसरी परसेप्शन ऑडिटरी विजुअल रिलेटेड टू पैनिक एंजाइटी एक्सट्रीम लॉन्लीनेस एंड विड्रॉल इनटू द सेल्फ एविडेंस बाय द इनएप्रोप्रिएट रेस्पॉन्स डिसऑर्डर थॉट सिक्वेंसिंग रैपिड मूड स्विंग्स पुअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एंड disorientation, then social isolation related to inability to trust, panic, anxiety, weak ego development, delusional thinking evidenced by the withdrawal, central affect, need, fear, dilemma, preoccupation with own thoughts, expression of feelings or rejection of the unknownness imposed by the other, potential risk for violence, self-directed or other directed related to extreme suspiciousness, panic, anxiety, catatonic excitement, rage reaction, command hallucination, evidence by the anxiety, catatonic excitement, rage reaction, command hallucination, evidence by overt and aggressive act, goal-directed destruction of object in the environment of self-destructive behavior or active aggressive suicidal act. Then impaired communication related to panic, anxiety, regression, withdrawal and disordered unrealistic thinking evidenced by loose association of ideas, neologism, word salad, clang association, echolalia, verbalization that reflect concentrate concrete thinking and poor eye contact. Self-care deficit related to withdrawal, panic, anxiety, perceptual or cognitive impairment, inability to trust, evidenced by difficulty carrying out tasks associated with hygiene, dressing, grooming, eating and toileting. Then disabled family coping related to difficulty coping with client illness, evidenced by the neglectful care of the client in regard to basic human need or illness treatment, extreme denial or prolonged over concern regarding client's illness, ineffective health maintenance related to disordered thinking or delusion evidenced by the reported or observed inability to take responsibility for meeting basic health practices in any or all functional pattern area. Then the impaired home maintenance management is related to regression, withdrawal, lack of knowledge or resource, or impaired physical or cognitive functioning evidenced by unsafe, unclear, disorderly home environment. Then the nursing interventions are decreased environmental stimuli like low lighting, low noise, few people, simple decoration, modify the environment to minimize objects, use furniture so heavy that it can not be lifted by client. Then remove all dangerous objects, glass, knife, blade or any sharp instrument with the patient from the client's environment when using restraint. Provide for safety evaluation, the patient status of hydration, nutrition and elimination. Arrange non-threatening activities that involve these patient in doing something. Help patient to participate in decision making as appropriate, example selecting the menu for the next day of meal. Then establishing therapeutic relationship by establishing trust. Then provide patient with opportunity for non-threatening socialization with the nurse on a one-to-one basis. Reinforce appropriate grooming by hygiene assist patient if needed. Make sure that one relative is always with the patient. Do not argue, criticize with psychotic thinking because they are real to the patient. Do not make promise which you cannot keep. Then explain each procedure before doing. Do not joke or judge the client's behavior. Assess the fluid and electrolyte status and feed high calorie, high, and listening to music. Engage client in reality based activities such as occupational therapy and listening to music. observe the client for sign of hallucination, try to find out the content of the hallucination. If the hallucination is of homicidal or suicidal, take necessary care for protect him or others. Then help the client understand and connection between anxiety and hallucination. Keep a comfortable distance away from the patient, arm length. Be prepared to move. Violent patient can strike out suddenly. Give needed information about the schizophrenia to the patient and relatives. It should be provided in simple language. Clear the doubts of relatives regarding the cause of illness and prognosis. Then the administer tranquilizing medication as ordered by physician. If client is not claimed by the medication, use of mechanical restraints may be necessary. Encourage client to perform independently as many activities as possible. Provide positive reinforcement for independent accomplishment. Provide assistance with self-care needs as required. Observed for side effects of drugs, record and report side effects of antipsychotic drugs. Then evaluates client response to medications and understanding teaching. Observe client's behavior frequently. Do this while carrying routine activities. Orient client to reality as required. Call the client by the name. Family should be instructed to regarding taking medication. Follow the treatment in long term. Explain about side effects of medication and how to deal with it. Then explain about extrapyramidal symptoms EPS or effects. Assign small responsibility. Encourage and support the patient. Supervise the activities. Appreciate even if it is a small task done by the patient. Avoid reaction and criticism. Watch the relapse. Sleepless will be earliest sign of relapse for these patients. Thank you everyone. Our topic schizophrenia is completed. Agar koi bhi query aapke topic se related hoti hai to aap please कमेंट कीजिए कमेंट बॉक्स के अंदर. उसका सॉल्यूशन अपन जल्दी से जल्दी करेंगे. सो थैंक यू एवरीवन अगेन.